live from their studios in England. You know you can pick up their new album, Dead Cities, as well as many other Astroworks releases at your local Virgin Megastore. And at the end of the two-hour broadcast, Groove Radio's own Christian B will spend some time with the guys from Future Sound of London, getting to know them just a little bit better. So without any further ado, through the miracle of ISDN, it's the Future Sound of London on the new 103.1 Groove Radio.
Transmit.
Oh.
Hello, LA. Groove Radio. Futures here. Sorry about the delay. The day started somewhat early here for us, but we're running things now.
Left to wander alone across this desolate land.
I know many things. Things that I feel. You are destined for great things. Within your heart. All dreams are possible.
Selflessness, intimacy, attraction, gentleness, understanding, and understanding without words.
Radio. You were right. You were right. And that's why tonight, before the entire nation, we'd like to apologize to you personally and to beg your forgiveness for all the things we did to you. And we'd like to thank you personally, all of us, for the meaning you've given our lives.
Entering audio copyright zone 2. Warning, spoiler technology is in use.
Thank you. Monica, KBCD FM, Newport Beach. The new 103.1 FM Groove Radio.
On any aspects of this broadcast, contact PO Box 1871, London W10 5ZL.
How about that? Thank you. I wish you all the best luck in the world.
We picture you cruising in fat automobiles, movie moguls leaving restaurants after late dinners, chilling out on beaches. Whatever you're doing, I hope you're enjoying FSOL Interruptus.
You've just joined the virtual universe.
Radio.
Hold it, hold it.
The future sound of London.
There must be some twitching ears out in LA at the moment. If you're one of the twitching few, and you're wondering what's going on, this is FS Sewell live via ISDN from London.
Alone in the dark with nothing but your thoughts. All I want is to be back where things make sense. Where I won't have to be afraid all the time.
I heard what you are. I heard Absolutely not.
Hello, Los Angeles. Groove Radio.
You are entering audio copyright zone 2. Warning, spoiler technology is in use.
Your future sound and rumble.
Yeah.
I look back on the way I was then. A young, stupid kid.
Angry humans here who hate us. Are we alive?
Are we alive?
Hello from London. You're listening to the FSOL virus coming transatlantic to you via ISDN. The interrupters. Stop reading, stop watching, stop making love, and listen. Cruise Radio.
future sound and rumble.
The rumors are true.
The rumors are true.
You really do exist.
You really do exist.
You really do exist.
You really do exist.
We're going to have a brief reprise before we keep going with the FSOL madness. While that's happening and we're reloading the samplers, this is Glass.
Santa Monica, KBCD-FM Newport Beach, the new 103.1 FM Groove Radio.
My name is of no consequence. I am the last who remembers how each of us, man and woman, we must die. Man made his own decision.
Thank you. Well, I don't know. That's up to you, dear.
No, well, if you disconnect, then can we just try again in 5 minutes?
Yeah, but I can't even understand the tape. What's it saying?
Oh, it's just saying the phone number.
Oh, is it?
You have reached the number. Don't worry about it. I'll ring the record company and tell them that we've tried a couple of times and got the answering machine and they'll have to rebook.
Do you want me to try it again, another five?
No.
FSOL nearing the end of a long stretch on Groove Radio.
You know the way everybody's into weirdness right now? You know the way everybody's into weirdness right now? You know the way everybody's into weirdness right now? It's all part of cosmic unconsciousness. A lot of people don't realize what's really going on. They view life as a bunch of unconnected incidents. They don't realize that there's this like lattice of coincidence that lays on top of them. Well, the way I see it, it's exactly the same. There ain't no difference between a flying saucer and a time machine. Where do all these people come from?
lights up, please. Leave them all up. Leave them on.
What's this, Walker?
Can you turn it up, please? Turn the lights up. Would you turn the lights off,
Thank you.
Okay, hold it, Brian. Okay, LA, do we have connection with you?
All I can say is, what an emotional experience, dude. I got a connection with you, man. Can you hear me?
Hello, hello.
Is there
LA.
Delay?
Hello.
We're here. Can you hear us?
Hello, LA.
Can I get Paoli quick?
Can you hear us? Do we have a Christian B in the house? Hello, hello. Can you hear me? This is kind of interesting, isn't it, Jean-Paul?
It's very nice.
Okay.
Very, very nice. Can they hear us now?
Can they hear us? Can you hear us?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes.
We have connection.
Excellent.
I must say,
really
this is
excellent.
This has been an emotional experience.
I hope so.
Yes, very much so. I must say, first of all, I have to say to everybody that you just got done listening to an exclusive ISDN broadcast by Astroworks recording artists, The Future Sound of London, live from the studio in England. And you can pick up the new album Dead Cities, as well as, of course, many other Astroworks releases at your local Virgin Mega store. So is this Gary?
Hey.
Is this?
Yeah, this is Gary. Cobain.
Gary, you're coming to us from the future, aren't you? Or is it the past?
No, very, very horribly in the present.
You know, I must ask, how many times have you done these ISDN concerts, virtual concerts in the United States?
You're priming me to say it's the first.
And you
and
did.
I think you would be right.
Terrific. I must say, we at Groove Radio, thank you very much for coming aboard and doing this.
You have actually...
No, thank you for having the innovation to realize that it would be a good idea. We enjoyed it. Although the time, obviously, was quite an odd one. 8 o'clock in the morning. I mean, normally I reserve this time for some meditation.
Terrific.
Some very rigorous dietary requirements.
Now, you guys have done this in other parts of the world.
Yes, indeed.
Yes, indeed. And that would include, I guess, in Italy. Is that correct?
Italy, Israel, Norway, Russia, Croatia, France, Italy. Yeah, and all over the UK as well.
This is just great. I've been listening to your music for, God, forever, for many years now. And being an electronic music lover myself, I have to say that I just really like this amazingly creative, genius music that you guys put out. And would like to know, actually, just personally, if... I guess you guys are continuously creating new music. I mean, almost what, on a daily basis?
I used to need to make music every day, but now I'm trying to live and bring my life experience to tracks. So at the moment, I'm living for a month and then going through a period of experimenting with seeing how my tracks change, how my music changes by trying to make each moment more powerful in a way, rather than constantly needing and feeling the need to prove myself by writing every day, which I must say for the last 4 or 5 years, it's almost become that way, almost become like I don't really want to become this 50-year-old who needs to prove himself every day by writing a great track. I mean, it got to the point where I couldn't go out socially in the evenings unless I'd written a great piece of music in the day, and that was quite worrying.
So almost like a neuroses.
Definitely a neuroses, yes.
That's so cool. You must read tons of philosophy. Are you big into different philosophies?
FSOL are into junk of any kind. We junk it together to try and form something new, whether that's philosophy or just complete trash, you know. We have no rules, really, you know. We're really into the idea of the coincidence. People recommending me things. Every time I'm recommended, if you would like to recommend me something, every time anybody recommends, I take. That's the way I lead my life. A series of coincidences and recommendations. So at the moment, I have 3 or 4 books on the go, yeah.
I must say the LA audience has been calling in all night and absolutely pissed that their tapes have run out. They were taping the show, and most of their tapes have run out because it went a little bit longer than we told them. And anyway, they really appreciate what you've done.
Wow, we appreciate them too.
So what's new for you guys in the future, man? Like, hopefully more albums, videos?
Yeah, an interesting period at the moment, I think. Actually, we're just getting back into... we've got a new single coming out called We Have Explosive.
Okay.
We've been working on that actually for the last 2 months because I think, as people will probably know by now, our singles are kind of albums.
Right.
So this one became even more insane and complex. But actually now we're actually getting back into something we haven't done for quite a few years, which is remixing, which our heads became ill for a while. Mm-hmm. We had an attitude about remixing which was unhealthy, so we desisted from it. But now we're getting back into it, and we've got some very nice... we're actually remixing an English band called Supergrass.
Mm-hmm.
Who we're really into, and it's a really nice opportunity, and looking forward to getting into that and just maximizing.
I have to ask, first of all, let me just say to our audience here, if you're just tuning in, we just got done listening to the Future Sound of London performing live in London. I guess it's what, about 10 and 11:30 in the morning.
10:30. I have a hypnotherapy session in half an hour.
Okay.
I'll go deep today.
I'll be quick. We'll wrap this up then in just a couple minutes so you can get on to your therapy. Anyway, I must say that you're listening to the Future Sounds of London, and I guess this is Gary, correct?
Gary Cobain.
Okay, terrific. I'm still talking to you.
You are.
Okay. As far as other artists, I'm a big Cabaret Voltaire fan, and I noticed... I read somewhere that I think you dig Cabaret Voltaire.
We plunder and rape the whole history of music, but amongst that garbage bin, that waste bin, there are people that we do like, and I guess because we take moments, little moments of things, I'd have to say that I like Barbara Streisand as much as I like Frank Sinatra, as much as I like Eno, as much as I like Kraftwerk, and that's kind of our attitude, really. But I must say, yeah, Cabaret Voltaire were a very big... I think the point here is they were a very big bonding force between myself and my brother, Brian. And when we came together, that was a mutual ground of understanding for us amongst our own particular madnesses. And, you know, I think at points, you know... At points, I think our divergence of taste has really, you know, led us into some dangerous ground. I remember... We did a Radio 1 session and we were mixing up other people's music, and I think Brian got slightly worried when I started spinning in Barbara Streisand and Jonathan King, Everyone's Gone to the Moon records, and so, you know,
that's
I
great.
Love anything that touches me, but Cabaret Voltaire definitely were influential for us both.
That's terrific, man. I'm a musician myself, and I have to say they definitely had some influence on me. And
you should get some tapes over to us, man, because I'd love to hear your stuff. We've just set up our Electronic Brain Violence label, mm-hmm. and we're just releasing our first thing, which is called Oil, Sleight of Hand, and that's an incredible piece of music, and it's really nice for me to have the opportunity to be a musical lover.
Excellent.
Rather than just a music maker. So at the moment, I'm really into just hearing stuff all around the world. So if there's anybody in LA that wants to send us tapes, we'd be more than pleased to receive them.
That's fantastic. We also, let's see here. I've got a question.
Are we going on to questions?
I've got a question for you, man.
Oh, how exciting.
As far as scoring any films, are you into doing that?
Well, funny enough, we took some very decisive moves this evening. That we took our cue from various tacky Hollywood movies. And we've actually hijacked various movie moguls around the city tonight, forced them into cars with nice sound systems, and hopefully by now they would have seen the wisdom of allowing us the freedom to score, hopefully, the new Space Odyssey. We've got various... I mean, actually, funny enough, actually, we are getting a lot of... we've got a track on the new Saint, heaven forbid, which is a remake of that classic old thing, starring Tom Cruise, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Maybe, and a new Marlon Brando movie as well. There's some various things going on. But, you know, we're continuing with our own audio-visual exploration, which I think is really going to be a lot more rewarding for us, rather than just providing tracks which are, you know, going to be slightly abused and misused. I mean, I love being abused and misused, so, you know, I like that too, but I'm really into just exploring this new kind of syntax that we're evolving at the moment with our own films and our own things. So we'll be continuing doing that and hopefully getting into some kind of live ISGN audio-visual environmental transmission this year as well, whereby we'll be setting up just weird environments and doing audio-visual downlinks to freak some heads.
You know, I totally believe in energies. Like, you know, we, as people give off energies with each other, I can feel such an amazing energy, dude, coming from just, I don't know exactly where, but it feels really cool. I have to ask you, like, a couple more questions, and I'll say goodbye for the evening, or for the morning, for you guys. Buggy G. Riphead, is that his name?
My man, Bugs, yeah.
Buggy G?
A very dear friend of ours, yeah. We've been through a lot of ups and downs, but that is his name, yeah.
Cool. Very,
Buggy G. Yep.
Yeah, all right, man, right on. And he produces, or does, I guess, the video visuals for you guys.
He's...
Sometimes,
yeah, I mean,
or...
Quite often it's mistaken that... I think, in a way, this is part of the modern-day fixation that, you know, you have a band and you have vultures that circle overhead that take care of things like visuals and, you know, photography and
so he doesn't necessarily do all your videos.
Well, no, he's very much part of the FSOL mess. You know, we have a team of animators and all people around us that have particular specializations.
Mm-hmm.
But all the mess eventually comes into this outfit, into the studio, and it's from here that the mess is disassembled into a new form. So Buggy G is very much part of and important to a lot of our iconic, some of our most iconic visual work, I think, has been done by Bugs, but mm-hmm. a lot of the other stuff is also done by us, and a lot, it's very much as much of a mess as the FSOL sound, you know. It's almost like there's about five stages to a track,
mm-hmm.
five stages to an image, and
mm-hmm.
at the end of the day, we're kind of left trying to claim what we did, and it was very difficult, you know, and it becomes this huge argument about what happened in the past, you know. It becomes insane, you know. Well, I got that bit, and, you know, I found this bit, and mm-hmm. I sampled that bit, and, you know,
well,
at the end of the day, you just say, well, who cares, you know.
I have one more question for you. Actually, a caller just called up and wanted to ask if you feel that ISDN, and actually, I guess all the modern technology is what they're trying to get at, has enabled you to reach your, or a personal vision of yours. I think it's great, personally, and I was just wondering, and so were they, what you feel about that. And then that'll be it for the evening.
I think our use of, yeah, I think certainly technology has empowered me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm also very wary, though, of allowing myself to fall into the hands of people that believe that technology is solely responsible for creativity. I just think, in a way, technology has enabled me to, in a very simple form, to lose my ego, in a way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I was brought up, I'm very much a bastard son, you know, bridging over from a rock and roll era. And I must say, I was brought up with music that I'm left with now, you know, more sort of traditional band stuff. And I found it very difficult to go against that. But I've lost my ego. I don't want to replicate what other people have, the ways in which other people have moved me. And
mm-hmm.
I think technology, if anything, has enabled me. We view it very much as a microscope.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very good way of just analyzing and reanalyzing information and analyzing your life and your emotions. And it's a modern-day microscope. And in that way, yes, it's definitely empowered me and enabled me to get a completely different vision on entertainment and the self.
I will end by saying that there's no doubt, at least in my mind, that this is absolutely wonderful, true art in its electronic form. And I think you guys, you and Brian, are absolutely terrific. And I welcome you back anytime. We appreciate being able to broadcast you guys to the city of Los Angeles right here in Groove Radio. And Gary, thank you so much for your time.
Tremendous, man. Much respect.
Okay.
Thanks a lot.
Take care, all right? Bye-bye.
Yeah, and you.
Thank
Bye-bye.
You. Bye. It was the Future Sound of London. And definitely welcome them anytime. What a great concert, huh, Jean-Paul?
very, very nice.
Very cool, very interesting. And I'm just kind of in another world right now, tripping out.
It's so nice. We've actually drawn the biggest overnight crowd here in the Groove Radio studios of 7 people.
That's absolutely correct.
Very nice, with a disco light and all rotating right now.
Jean-Paul, of course, the raving reporter. Roving rave reporter. And I'm going to go ahead and play some of these for a moment, and we'll be back with Papua New Guinea.